Hi everyone, this is Seema Mehta from the Confident Communicator in conjunction with the release of our Personal Almanac / Planner, My Life, My Way. This is a series of interviews we are doing with very strong and inspiring women of substance, honoring them from March 1st to March 8th, which happens to be the International Women's Day. One woman we have today who is exactly fitting that profile is a dear friend of mine, Arati Kumar-Rao. Hi, Arati. How are you doing?
Hello, Seema. Great to be here. Doing fine. Thank you.
So let me talk about Arati a little bit. Arati Kumar-Rao is a National Geographic Explorer, independent environmental photographer, writer, and artist documenting the slow violence of ecological degradation. For the past 6 years, she has crisscrossed the South Asian subcontinent, sometimes following a single story across seasons and over years, in order to chronicle South Asia's changing landscapes and climate and its effect on livelihood and biodiversity. Let me tell you, she's always traveling and she goes to all these strange places, and we always hear these wonderful stories from her, and she's so cool. In her work, she communicates through photographs, long-form narratives and art, and is working on her very first book, which we are waiting to see. And Arati is, of course, based in Bangalore. So Arati, shall we just get right into it?
Sure thing.
So my first question to you is, tell us a little bit about yourself, your whole process. You know, I know you used to be working in a hardware company, a very famous hardware company. You had a very different role and a different life, and then you moved into something completely different. So yes. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, I think I would be what you would call your classic wanderer, because all through right from when I was a teenager, I always wanted to study science and arts. And you know, at that time in India, the colleges would not allow you, they'd force you to choose, right? You'd have to either take science or arts. So I had to pick between the two, and I chose science. And so I went all the way through, did a master's in biophysics, joined a lab, and I realized that that was just not for me. And so I quit overnight and looked for a job in journalism, because writing is what I loved. And a glossy magazine in Bombay, which still runs, called Society, was the one that just took a chance on me, and I became a cub reporter there, and I loved it. I was there for a year. And then, of course, I wandered again, went to the US. I wasn't corporate, like you mentioned. So I think I'm now, when we came back, I decided to quit and do what I really love, which is storytelling. So get back to my first love. But, you know, if I had to count the different careers I've had in my life, this is probably my sixth avatar. So,
yes. You're wandering. Your feet are always moving. We know that. We're always looking to find you somewhere. Yes, we know about that.
Yeah.
So Arati, my next question, of course, is I know you've gone through so many different phases in your life. You looked at a lot of different things, and these are your journeys where you arrived at what you're most passionate about, apart from the environment and photography, which you combined and became a photojournalist. If you had to give an advice to your 20-year-old, because a lot of our viewers are these very young first-time jobbers who are just getting into the corporate scene, or who are confused, they don't know what to do with their lives, what advice would you give somebody who's around 20 years of age?
Yeah, if
or
I had to look
yourself,
back...
Even to yourself.
Yeah, to myself too. And I think that was when I started wandering and I wasn't sure what I wanted to do. But then I think the one thing I would say is, don't live someone else's life. You know, don't let anyone else define what you should be, or who you should be, or how you should behave, what you should do in your life or as a career, anything, right? Go inward, listen to what your instinct says, what you think, you know, you want to do or what you're good at. But then work like really deep, really hard, get so good at it that people can't ignore you anymore. And I think I would tell myself to stick with that voice and not get swayed.
That's really good advice, but easier said than done, don't you think? I mean, I'm sure, you know, with your marriage and your daughter and raising a family, that there must have been a few challenges. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yes. So I think if I look back, you know, it's easy to say what I just said now. And there are so many pressures on, especially women in India at that time. And you know, when you're going through that, you don't quite realize, you don't have the wherewithal to make such decisions. But I think now, I think I would also say, don't be afraid to wander. Don't be afraid to try something. So for me, if I look back, getting married, going to the US, having a child, all of that, it's added up to where I am right now. And I don't think the storyteller that I am right now would be as accomplished or as rich without those experiences. So I think it all adds up, you know, and it's invaluable. So don't be afraid to wander. If it's something that you think you like, but you try it and you don't like it, don't be afraid to change. And
what you're saying is, trust your instinct, go with your gut, go with what you are most passionate about and chase it. So, I mean, you kind of answered the question, but I'm going to still ask you. So how are you living your life your own way?
It's taken a while, you know, even though you're doing what you really like and you're working hard for it, you're still beholden to expectations, you know, your own expectations, someone else's expectations, all of that, right? And I think now where I am in life, I have come to a point where I'm allowing myself time to absorb my learnings at my pace, you know, doing things at my pace. If I want to do absolutely nothing for 3 days, I do absolutely nothing for 3 days. I don't allow someone to say, what did you do today, you know, or you've not delivered anything, you know, the deliverables. That's kind of something that I have absolutely jettisoned, thrown away. And I think I've listened to, I'm not letting any labels define me. So some people ask me, are you a photographer or are you a writer? And I'm like, why can't I be both? You know, I'm both. I'm a storyteller, and I'll use whatever tools at my disposal to tell a good story. If it's photographs, that's what it is. If it's video, it's something, or words, whatever, right? So I'm not letting labels or someone else's timeline, even if it is my own editor's timeline. I'm famous for defining my own deadlines, so, and flouting them too. But
it sounds like you are sort of defining what you want, and you are setting the rules for yourself. You are looking inwards. You are deciding the course in which you're going to go. And obviously they come with challenges. There are expectations, like you said, and most women do have those expectations more than I would say men do, because we are natural, nurturers and caretakers. So I completely hear you. And I think it's a constant battle, isn't it? It's kind of like an internal fight and journey that you go through. Right.
Yes, it's a constant struggle. And also the fact that I think we tend to put shackles on ourselves. And it's been a learning for me to tell myself that nobody's telling me not to do this. I cannot do it if I don't want to, you know. So, you know, that kind of thing too. We stop ourselves, we censor ourselves, we do so many things to ourselves. And I've been trying every day.
That is why your story is so, so inspiring. And that is why this is a wonderful book that we are going to be sending you. It's a planner, it's a personal almanac, it's an organizer, it allows you to create your dream list, it has a gratitude jar, it has all the things that you would require to make your vision come true. And we are so delighted to speak to you that we're going to send you this wonderful copy for your use. Thank you so much, Arati, for your time. It was fabulous talking to you. And I'm sure a lot of viewers are going to be very, very inspired by this talk.
Thank you, Seema, and I wish all of them very well, and I can't wait to have that book in my hands.
Thanks, Arati.